everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 16 Developer Beta 8. This is available to developers, and hopefully very soon the public beta will be out, usually the same day, a little bit later, or the following day. It just depends from week to week, as Apple has changed it up. And this is the only thing Apple released today so far, just iOS 16 Beta 8. No watchOS, no iPadOS, macOS, HomePod, or tvOS have been released as far as new beta updates, so maybe those are more complete. Now, this came in at a fairly small 222.2 megabytes. That's on my 13 Pro Max, and it was anywhere between 150 to 250 megabytes on the devices you'll see here. Now, let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About, and you can see this build number is also an A at the end of it. It's 20A5358A. So again, it's close to a final build, but not the absolute final build, as that would be released with a release candidate. And this particular update does not have a modem update. In fact, Apple has carried over the same modem update, 2.09.01 on the 13 Pro Max, from Beta 5 all the way up to Beta 8. So there's no major changes to the modem, but that doesn't mean they couldn't resolve issues going on in the background. As far as new features, well, iOS 16 development is complete, which means features are done. Basically, we shouldn't see any major changes or anything. They're working on bugs and battery life and trying to get everything fixed as far as that goes before the final release of iOS 16. As I went through looking for different things such as changes with the settings and changes with the lock screen, it looks like everything is complete. This is feature complete, and we may have features released a little bit later with iOS 16.1. As we already know, iPadOS 16.1 and macOS 13 Ventura have been delayed a little bit, probably until October. There's no new splash screens that I was able to find. I went into every single Apple app, so Photos, Clock, Camera, Reminders, Notes, every single one of them, and wasn't able to find a single new splash screen. No new information there. Within the code, there were small changes for Apple Watch, possibly for the upcoming Apple Watch Series 8, but no new visual changes, no new wording changes even this time around. So there's no wording changes throughout the OS like there typically is update to update. And so this is really about bug fixing and battery life. And if we go into the feedback app, at least the last time I checked, there was no new updates for even the notes. So we still have beta 7. They haven't updated it as far as beta 8. So we don't even know what's specifically new in this as far as any bug fixes. However, we can tell a few different things just by using this so far, as quite a few people have reported that banking apps seem to be working well. There may be exceptions to this, and usually that's due to the banking app needing an update in the App Store. So different banking apps will need different updates, and hopefully they'll update those probably by the time it's finally released to the public. As far as messages freezing and locking up, at least so far, using this over the past hour or so, it's been pretty good. I know some people were having that issue, so hopefully that's resolved. Spotlight search definitely seems to be nice and fast, going in searching for things such as Apple, or maybe just going into music and searching here, it seems to work as well. Prior to this update with Beta 7, some people reported that lyrics searching wasn't working. So if we type something such as "we're halfway there," let's see if it brings up anything related to that. And it looks like it does. Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer. So pretty old song, but it's searching for lyrics across Apple Music, where it didn't work at all for me in Beta 7. And so that seems to be fixed. Setting wallpaper seems to be fixed. And also the storage bug for most people seems to be fixed, where it wouldn't load at all. As far as the overall storage itself, that shouldn't be much of an issue, as it's going to use some of the things in the background to better make the overall experience and performance better. So we'll give this a moment to load. It will take a moment the first time it loads. And as it's loading, you can see as we scroll down all the way to the bottom, this is buried at the bottom, so you don't have to pay attention to it. So things like system data, this is more system cache, and it's probably going to be very large, 20 to 40 gigabytes lately for me. It can vary, but I really wouldn't pay too much attention to that unless you're out of storage overall. So I really wouldn't mind that too much. You'll see it's still calculating, and I really wouldn't pay attention. Let's take a look here. It's 42.26 gigabytes for me. So that's going to free itself up as we need it for different apps and more. Again, like I said, as far as known and resolved issues, Apple hasn't specified anything in the feedback app. Let's check one more time to see if they've updated it. And so far, nothing new. So we'll have to wait and see if they even update it this time around. And this is probably the last beta before the release candidate. And so that leads me to, should you install iOS 16 beta 8? At this point, absolutely. If you're on beta 7, if you're on public beta 5, once public beta 6 is out, if it is by the time of this video, definitely install that, get that going, and make sure you're reporting feedback if you're having issues. As far as iOS 16 release candidate, well, now that we know that Apple's event is on next, well, a week from now or so, on the Wednesday of next week, the 7th, we know that we'll have iOS 16 RC after that event. At least that's what Apple's done every single year since I can remember. Typically, we'll have the announcement of the iPhone 14 at the Apple Far Out event. Then we'll also have the iPhone 14, 14 Max, 14 Pro, 14 Pro Max, and then probably Apple Watch Series 8, maybe even some surprises and some more, maybe one more thing going on there, maybe even the Apple VR AR headset. So those things we know about. Then typically after that, they'll release the iPhone pre-orders, usually the following Friday, so on the 9th. Then they'll release the iPhone 14 for sale on the 16th. Usually the Monday before that is when they'll release iOS 16 to the public. So it could be Monday to Wednesday, but I'm expecting September 12th to be the final release date of iOS 16. Again, it could be a couple days after that, but that's typically what Apple does every single time. And so we're at the very end of what this should be like. So right now they're perfecting battery and getting rid of all of the remaining bugs so that we can have the best experience possible. And as far as overall battery life, well, that does take a few days to measure. I've talked about that many times, but we can take a look at it. For me, over the past few days, my battery health, let's go back in here. Battery health is currently at 98%. It's finally dropped again another point. I would completely expect that at this point, being that it's about a year old. And if we take a look at yesterday, I had 2 hours and 6 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 34 minutes of screen off time, and used about 25 to 27, 30% of my battery life. So that's pretty good overall. That would get me through a day, no problem. And usually by the time I put this on the charger, I have 50 to 60% of my battery life left. I do expect this to improve though, hopefully with this update. As far as the overall performance, it's been pretty good. First, let's talk about the heat though, because it's nice and cool now. Initially, installing an update, it will get warm, especially if you're charging it, but now it's nice and cool, no issues there. And also, the performance overall seems to be nice and smooth, whether you're on an older phone or a newer phone. So if we go over here, just scrolling back and forth, and scrolling with ProMotion is nice and fast as well, of course. Now let's take a look at the benchmarks as I ran them on all of these devices here. So we'll go over to Geekbench. And on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, I did run this twice as the initial scores were pretty low for multi-core. That sometimes happens right after running the update, but I scored 1,711 for single core, 4,719 for multi-core. Week over week, that's pretty good. Again, I ran that twice. You can see it here. It's definitely faster for the multi-core score on both of the times I ran it before. And also, it's about average for single core. It's within spec, usually 1 or 200. So that's pretty good. Now let's take a look at all of these devices. Now the devices here all have beta 8 on them. The iPhone 11 has beta 7, so I can look back and forth for new changes. And you'll see on the left, we're starting with the iPhone 8 Plus, then the iPhone 10, then the iPhone XR, then the iPhone 13 Pro Max. And again, this is just to give you a general idea of what to expect if you have any of these devices or any that are within sort of the overall release date of these devices. And so with that, that's pretty much everything with iOS 16 Beta 8. I would not expect a whole lot more, basically bug fixes, battery life improvements, and overall performance improvements. That's what we're looking for at this point, and hopefully we'll see much more of that over the next few days. Of course, I'll have a follow-up on the weekend to see how it is for everyone and if we find anything else. And if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.